RNIB, supporting blind and partially sighted people.
Getting interested in technology.
Having access to technology can enhance almost every aspect of our lives. Being included is very much about being connected. Whether it's for online shopping, internet banking, or simply staying in touch with friends or family, technology plays a pivotal role in everyone's lives. It's very, very simple to get started with technology, and you can learn bit by bit, day by day. So in this short series of videos, we've broken down all of the popular topics and questions around technology, and we've made it really simple and really user-friendly, and we hope that you find it to be a very valuable resource.
Chapter 1, Screen Magnification and Screen Readers.
Hi, I'm Robin Spinks, I'm 39, I'm partially sighted, and I've been using technology since I was a kid. I'm also using magnification on mobile and desktop devices.
Oh, hi, I'm Ellie Southwood. I've got no useful vision, so I use a screen reading software, and I use it for everything that I do on the internet.
Hi, I'm Ian Gentle. I have a degenerative condition. I now have no central vision, but I have peripheral vision on the left side of my left eye, and now I use a combination of magnification and screen reader.
Now let's first of all talk about screen magnification. Screen magnification does exactly what it says on the tin. Screen magnification makes everything on your screen look bigger.
Robin, is that literally everything on the screen?
Basically everything that's on the screen. So it'll magnify the menus, the icons, any information about battery, time, etc. And you can make it bigger in increments, so you can go up a little bit at a time, you can find exactly the right level that works for you, and you can also change the colours and the contrast. Now Ian, you're a magnification user, aren't you?
Yes, I am. I started off with a program called Magnicomp, and then I graduated onto a program called ZoomText Extra.
Presumably, Ian, you can only get so much on the screen when it's much bigger, so you might not have everything there at the same time. How does that work? Do you find that manageable?
Well, what the options are in the professional programs is you can actually split the screen. Say you split it horizontally, the top half could be magnified, whereas the bottom half contains a smaller version of the whole screen. Mm-hmm. So you could move your cursor around the bottom screen, knowing where you are, and wherever the cursor stops will be magnified at the top.
If you are losing your vision, you're concerned about your ability to be able to use a computer, actually there are many opportunities there and there are many products available that can help, so you needn't give up. Now, if you are someone who doesn't have useful vision and actually you need to navigate your device, you can do that using something called a screen reader. And as the name suggests, a screen reader will quite simply read out all of the information that's on screen of your device. But more than that, it will allow you to fully navigate the device and to navigate menus.
Of course, they come in all shapes and sizes, don't they? So I use one called Jaws, but people have their own preferences in terms of the voices.
At first, I remember when I first heard these voices, I thought, I'm never, ever going to get used to this because it is so alien.
How do you have yours set?
Well, I started off using the basic verbosity where it speaks absolutely everything. After a while, because I got better at using it, then I went to a middle level of verbosity, so it would speak some of the information and the text. These days, I'm super, so it just reads the text on the screen or whatever piece of menu I want it to read.
Mm. And Robin, do you find that most sort of older people, perhaps who are losing sight, is it Guide the one that people like to use?
That's right. Dolphin Guide is a really well-designed product that allows an older person to navigate a computer really simply using speech. And what's really nice about it is that it also redesigns the entire interface of the computer and offers it up in a much simpler form.
The other really good one is NVDA, isn't it? Which has improved lots in recent years and is free,
yes.
Which is obviously always brilliant.
So getting started with screen magnification and screen readers, first of all, check what comes out of the box on your computer. There are built-in screen reading and screen magnification options on the main platforms, so on Windows and Mac. And also there are options for Linux if anyone's using that. And for mobile devices, increasingly there are built-in screen readers and screen magnifiers. And get the chance to try out some of the other screen readers and find out if they work for you. So thanks very much, both of you, for your contributions. As we've heard, lots of positive things out there, lots of resources available. And if you want more information on this topic, you can find out by getting in touch via the helpline.
For more information, please contact the RNIB helpline on 0303 123 9999 or email digitalaccess@rnib.org.uk. Copyright of RNIB, January 2013. Registered charity number 226227. Supported by BT.
RNIB, supporting blind and partially sighted people.